Hi everyone, Sanavi here, and happy holidays to you all. My apologies if my voice isn't quite itself. I've been under the weather with a nasty cold lately, which is why I've been silent in my most recent videos. But today, I'm excited to review a build that's caught my eye, even though it's not one of my own creations. I've been eager to try it out this league. We're looking at the Voidforge Animate Guardian, a build that's been around now for quite some time. I'm testing it with the new Transfigured Animate Guardian gem and the latest Affliction Charms. The updated AG skill gem, especially with its smite ability, adds a nice touch to the clearing process, but it's the animated weapons that are the stars here, delivering the main damage and clear speed. And to be honest, a standard AG gem would work just as well. Some notes on the gear. We are using Chains of Command to summon animated weapons based on our AG's equipped weapon, the Voidforge. The setup includes Gravevine Gloves on the AG, making every kill count as its own. This is crucial because it activates the main trigger mechanism on Chains of Command, which creates a cascade of the weapons quickly. And that's the first line, trigger level 20 Animate Guardian's weapon, when the animated guardian kills an enemy. Another key component is the Leash of Ablation, which allows us to utilize all three offerings simultaneously. This not only boosts our minions' offensive and defensive capabilities, but it synergizes perfectly with our build's focus on duration. And we scale this duration extensively both through our ascendancy and specific nodes on the skill tree. And since we're capping both regular and spell block on the build, surrender is a prime choice to scale our effective hit pool. The rest of the gear is pretty standard and up to how much you want to invest. I will say one last item to note is the Writhing Jar, which we use to get the build up and running in a fresh instance. I prefer to use one for mapping and two for bossing. We invest into the Essence Extraction Wheel on the passive skill tree, and we anoint our amulet with replenishing remedies to get the charges back up quickly, as you can see here. For the new charms, we're utilizing the following three. Increased effect of our marks, and removes bleeding when you use a flask. This is especially nice because we're not using regular life flasks, so we have a corrupted blood cannot be inflicted on us, and then we have the remove bleed whenever we use a flask. We're also using Explosion when our minions do damage, and a little bit of ES regen. And then we're using Mana Reservation and cannot be stunned by hits you block. And since we're blocking all the time, we're pretty much almost effectively stun immune. Another combination I've added recently is a 60% reduced extra damage from crits on a Watcher's Eye, as well as a 40% reduced extra damage from crits when we curse something to effectively be crit immune, especially when we're fighting a boss. A heads up, this build is on the pricier side, so it's not the best starter. It's more of a fun mid-game bossing build. I've swapped to it from an existing character, and I've been using it mainly for targeted boss farming, and I've really been enjoying it. You'll find an updated path of building in the description for my version. It includes a gear set with all the items for the AG, as well as current items I'm using. I'm still fine-tuning it, but I'm also eyeing other archetypes to try out with new gems in the upcoming weeks, so this probably will be my last minion build of the league. I hope you find this helpful, and enjoy the build as much as I did.
Troy must enjoy our contests.